started to do graffiti when I was quite young, when I was 13, painting walls and illegal walls and then trains. I kept doing it, but I was doing legal walls too with the crew that I had at the time. So I started to look into, you know, what I was doing and the impact that the work that you do outside has to the public. I end up looking into my first memory of a wall that was painted. It was like 5, 6, and we used to see these few old murals from the revolution period that we had in 74. My father was an influence because he was an activist on it. And I remember when I was a kid that I saw these walls that were kind of left-wing, but they were looking to the future and, you know, to sort of utopia kind of dream that got everyone together. Then in the middle of the 90s, we had a big boom with advertising and went over these murals, these political murals that were part of history in a way. And then more advertising, more graffiti. And then the council started to clean it and paint it all white. So it was like the streets or the walls in the city were reflecting the changes that were going through 20, 30 years. The walls were getting fatter, you know, centimeter by year because of all these layers that were building up. I was doing stencil, I was exploring stencil, and I started to see stencil not as something that you paint over, but as a window that makes you see through. So I started by carving the billboards, paint them white, carve them, and it was a comment mostly on identity and how advertising affects you in the way you are and in your aspirations, dreams and so on. Why should I be one more layer on top of these whole layers? And then eventually I went to the walls and carve on the walls and expose the bricks and what's inside. The faces are a big part of my work. You humanize a place. If you put a face in a place, people can relate to it. Carving a wall, scratching a wall with a face of a person, it's kind of poetic in the sense that people carve their own cities and cities are carved by the same people. The street art scene in Lisbon, it's really DIY in one sense because people have to do with what they have. There is no support from both like galleries or the government or anything, so it's pretty, you know, people have to do with what they have. I consider myself an activist. I try to give places to artists in Lisbon, try to get them their voice heard. There is no money, so people do it for the sake of it. And I think, you know, that's kind of what makes it special. It was making sense for the work to go elsewhere because in a way, all these places, when you go to Shanghai and you see in 20 years, it was fields, like agricultural fields, and now it's the biggest concentration of skyscrapers. You see that the layers of evolution there were even faster than what I saw here. I'm trying to make the people that see the art reflect on the changes that are going through in our cities and the pace of the changes that are affecting us in a way that sometimes we don't realize. But it's always with playing with the chaos of materials and the ephemerality of it, which is what we have in the cities that we live in and with us, because in the end we are chaotic and ephemeral.